Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy, and today's video will share the journey of my husband and I setting up our new aquarium tank. Now, one of the things we wanted to do with this project was to keep it fairly simple and to stay within a strict budget, in which case we're using a 10-gallon tank and some supplies that I already owned, but we did get a few new things with a gift card that we had. To start off, we got this Higer LED aquarium light, and I'll put the link in the description if you're interested, but this light has a bunch of customizable features and color options, which is largely why my husband chose this one, because he knows I love colored lights and that we both would enjoy the custom options on this. It also has 8 programmable settings, which are spread out through 24 hours to replicate the sun's natural cycle, such as starting low and warm-toned in the morning, getting bright and white at midday, progressing to sunset, and then a dim blue moonlight or blackout setting for nighttime. We also got a glass canopy hinged lid to prevent water evaporation and to keep any critters from crawling or jumping out. Next, we got an AquaClear 30 filter, which is technically way more than a 10-gallon needs for filtration, but we wanted to get something that's a step up rather than something that barely keeps up with the bio load. So this filter situation turned into a small ordeal because initially we ordered one in like new condition from Amazon's warehouse, which we had never tried ordering anything from there before, and they sent us 2 gross, beat up, cracked filters that weren't even the correct brand or size that we had ordered. So we had a chuckle, shipped them back, and then reordered and got a new perfect condition AquaClear 30. Lastly, we got some test strips and a pack of food. So at this point, we had all of the basics and we were able to set the tank up with water. The black gravel was something I already had on hand, and we went ahead and poured it in and waited for the water cloudiness to clear up. Some of you longtime subscribers might remember my 2 moss balls named Mary and Mo. I know, very creative, right? Surprisingly, I still have them, and I went ahead and took them out of their little glass bowl and I put them into the 10-gallon tank. They definitely aren't looking as green as they did in past, but I think the LED light, the warmer water, and the plant fertilizer will help them bounce back again. Speaking of fertilizer, we have this bottle of Fluval Grow Plus that we'll be using to put nutrients into the water, since there will be live plants in this tank. But we're not getting all fancy with CO2 and all of that right now. This is just the basic tank setup. So here's where I'll insert some pet store footage, because I made quite a few visits to scout out plants and aquatic life. And I'll also insert a few hamster clips at the end, because obviously I had to stop by the hamster section and see what they had. They're almost always sleeping during the day, of course, so it's really hard to ever get footage of hamsters being up at pet stores, but I tried to get a little bit of footage for you all. Back to our aquarium at home, my husband had the brilliant idea to set up river rocks into a sloped shape that looked natural, but still interesting. So I spent about half a day working on carefully stacking the rocks, making sure they were each secure and stable so they wouldn't fall down and squish any critters. So in my next video, we will be going back to the pet store to pick out a plant or two, or three or four maybe, and to get our aquarium cycle going before we introduce any critters. So for critters, our hope is to eventually have probably just one mystery snail, maybe a few shrimp, and possibly a betta fish. We definitely want to add our livestock in slowly to make sure that the beneficial bacteria is able to take care of the ammonia and the nitrites, and that everything is really stable before we start putting too much stuff in it. So I will see you all in my next video, and that's going to be kind of a part two of setting up our tank. I hope you enjoyed watching this, and have a great day. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!